Welcome to this review of Mother for the Famicom. I'm Arachne, and sorry for the mess. A lamp jumpy, and I need to clean all the shards around here. They're pretty easy to break, I guess. Just pick a baseball bat and... all over the place. Oh, you probably know this game as Earthbound Beginnings by now. Nintendo decided to release it 5 years ago on the Wii U. If you don't know what a Wii U is, that's not important. Just Nintendo thinking they could poorly market a console, create a weird pad-like controller, then have the worst ever E3 presentation, and get away with it. But it stuck there, unless you find yourself a copy like I did for the Famicom. Almost forgot. Huge thanks to Tomato and Jeffen for releasing a translation in English for this one in 2011. So these games have been inspired by Dragon Quest. In fact, a couple characters were referenced. That actually fits the game since it's set in 1989. Yeah, this is a refreshing take on RPGs since there is no cape and sword. Well, no cape. But it's all very modern feeling, and it's clearly set on our planet Earth, even if all places have different names. The game's story has to do with Anna's mother, hence the title. She has gone missing, and so a lot of other adults, leaving an entire city with only the children. It seems a lot of people and animals have gone crazy since the arrival of mysterious beings called Starmen, without taking into consideration how many inanimate objects have sprung to life trying to kill everything in their sights. As said before, this is an RPG, specifically of the turn-based kind, but, like Dragon Quest, it tries to make enemy encounters much more unique than the majority of the games in the genre. Because at least 80% of the mobs you encounter have their own unique attack and therefore require you to become knowledgeable about them. This happens since the very beginning, making the whole encountering much less boring. I feel like the majority of turn-based role-playing games don't even try to give you any challenge until the midway point, if ever. Mother feels really new in that sense. It's the rest of the gameplay that it's a slug to go through. So many interactions require you to go through menu commands. It's the reason why I'm gonna play most Dragon Quest games on Super Nintendo instead of the NES. I guess that's also faithful to the NES games that I have already mentioned 300 times. But something being similar to another game doesn't make it good. Exploring, for example, is confusing. There's an in-game map, but there's only so much they could do with it. Lots of places are just somewhere in the middle of the forest, and you don't know how to get to them. Also, at various points in the game, you will be required to buy an item, but nobody really tells you where it is. This is the kind of stuff that dates these games badly. I can't go on talking about this without talking about the music. So, since these titles are really all about pulling ideas from Itoi, creating a director of all of the aspects of the Mother franchise, he obviously directed the music to sound like the genres he likes. So you get stuff like rock, synth-pop, and traditional Japanese music, creating all together a mesh that makes you feel like you're going through new topical radio stations. For the time, of course. It sounds really good for being chiptunes, and there are memorable compositions that people still listen and talk about today. In the end, this is a very good game, but it doesn't stand against its two sequels. Not even close. That's why I give it an honest 7. The series still has to find its shine, but there's already some hints of great potential. Feel free to discuss this video, the review, and the channel in the comment section below. Hope you have fun on here. If you wanna keep up with what I do, follow me on Twitter at @arachniretro. See ya at the next review. Bye bye!